Welcome to my YouTube channel. I am Breezy Gamer, and I'm going to be telling you guys what a tattoo feels like. So my tattoo, it's kind of small. It looks big on me because I'm really tiny, but this is a color tattoo. A big thing you gotta remember is color tattoos and classic black and white tattoos, there's a difference between the pain. Black and white tattoos are gonna, they still hurt, but they're not gonna hurt as much. This one hurt a whole lot. It also depends on how much you weigh, like proportion wise. Like, I'm really, really small. I'm under 5 feet tall and I'm under 90 pounds, believe it or not. So I'm pretty skinny. And so the skinnier you are, unfortunately, it's gonna hurt more. So if you weigh like a bit more, like if you're overweight or if you're like curvy or plus size, like depending on how tall you are, then it's gonna hurt less because the more like flesh and the more fat you have on your arms or whatever body part you're getting the tattoo done, the less it will hurt because the farther away it is from your bone. The worst spots are on your ribs, on your fingers or your feet. Or like if you have a sensitive part of your body, like obviously genitals are really sensitive. My underarm, when he did the tattoo on this side, it started to hurt like a little more because it was starting to get close to under my arm, which apparently is more sensitive. It all depends on who you are. Everyone has different sensitive spots on their body. My shoulder, when he went up here, it hurt really, it didn't hurt really bad, but it felt like he was like pushing on my bone. So you can definitely feel the difference in pain. Also, color, they have to push it in more. The needle doesn't necessarily go deeper in you, but they have to go at that spot repeatedly multiple times, so it gets annoying and it hurts. This one burned horribly. It burned really badly. If you're gonna get a color tattoo and you're skinny or underweight, it's gonna hurt really, really badly, so just be prepared. It feels like a needle is poking you while it's on fire. It's not the needle pain where when you get a shot, it's not that type of pain. It's a whole different pain. So let's say this is a pen. I'm not gonna tell you to try this at home because that'd be bad, but if you take a pen and lay it on the side of your arm like this and go like that, so the needle's scraping you but it's not stabbing you, that's how it feels like. And so if it's in color, like no matter what, it's gonna feel like that scraping kind of burning needle pain. But if it's in color, it's gonna hurt way more than if it wasn't black and white. If you have more meat on your bones, if you're a little thicker, it's probably gonna hurt less than mine. I'm definitely not getting a tattoo again because this pain was really bad. And even 2 days after I got it, it was still hurt, it still burned. This is still pretty fresh. It's like 3 or 4 days old. It's really sensitive to anything that touches it. I think for the first 3 days, I had to wear tank tops just because anything that touched my arm, it would hurt really bad, like a sunburn kind of feeling. That's how it would feel like. And I would have like a fan on it because it's still burned. It's still a little sensitive to the touch right now, but it is healing. And when you're done with your tattoo, a few days after, it's gonna like turn into a one big scab. Like, this doesn't look like a scab. It's not gonna be a bloody scab. It's gonna be like when you move, you're gonna see it's wrinkly. That's like, it's the best way to describe it as a scab. Like, it's like the tattoo turns into a scab, and then over time it's gonna peel off naturally. Do whatever your tattoo artist tells you. My artist told me wash it twice a day and apply Aquaphor, I think once or twice a day, I'm not sure. But I bought Hustle Butter, and so I'm starting to use that. And it's a cream, you can use it while your tattoo is healing. It's gonna help the healing process more. And you can use it after your tattoo is fully healed to keep the colors vibrant and to help it stop from fading. So even if you have a black and white tattoo, I do recommend using Hustle Butter. I've only used Hustle Butter once. I literally bought it today and I just put it on now, and you don't need that much. Like, my tattoo is like, I don't know, like 3 inches, 4 inches big, and I needed like this much and it covered my whole tattoo. So it goes a really long way. So the Hustle Butter, I got it, mine was like $19.99, basically 20 bucks, but it's gonna last you a really long time depending on how big or how many tattoos you have. But this tattoo is probably gonna last me a long time because like literally this much cover this whole thing. And the tub is like this big. Like, it's a, you get a lot if you have a small tattoo. It's gonna last you a really long time. So yeah, it's basically what a tattoo feels like for first timers. Cause everyone always told me that it does feel like a burning cat scratch. The longer it takes, this took like 2.5 hours. And after a while, it started hurting really more because as you're getting tattooed, your arm starts to swell. And once it swells and they keep tattooing you, it's gonna hurt even more because your skin's sensitive and that needle and burning going in you is gonna make it hurt a whole lot more. So yeah, it hurt a lot for me. I'm not getting another one. I don't care if it's in black and white. I don't care if it's big tattoo, small tattoo. I'm not getting another one. And it also depends on your pain tolerance. Like, I didn't cry when I got this. It hurt a whole lot, but it wasn't enough to make me cry. I could still bear it. I mean, obviously, once you start tattoo, you kind of can't stop. So just remember that. Once you start, you cannot stop unless you want an unfinished tattoo. So just remember to keep that in mind. And yeah, that's basically how it goes. I hope this helped you guys. I hope this helped anybody who plans on getting a tattoo. Just be prepared. So if you're a skinny mini like me, it's most likely gonna hurt a whole lot. Even if you get it on your butt cheeks, which usually is the fast part of your body, still probably gonna hurt. My arm hurt a whole lot. Obviously my arm isn't as fat as my booty cheeks. So who knows, but just always be prepared for the worst. And remember, once you start, you cannot stop unless you want something unfinished. So just remember that if you're thicker than I am, which everybody is thicker than me because not many people are underweight, it might not hurt as much. If you can't really tolerate pain, like if you stub your toe and you cry to stubbing your toe, do not get tattooed because this is like a million toe stubs, all right? So I hope this helped everybody. Have a great day. Remember to like, comment, share, subscribe, whatever you do on YouTube. Just thank you all for watching. I helped you guys. If you want any more videos of any kind, just let me know. And I'll see all of you in the next video.